Hey you guys, how's it going? Just left my neurofeedback appointment today and I also had therapy today. I felt like I was doing fine, but my therapist basically gave me a lot to think about, and so I was distracted in my neurofeedback.
But today I do feel like my medicine's working. I feel like the neurofeedback is making a significant change.
Neurofeedback is not something that's just gonna totally cure your issues. It also takes a lot of work on self, and that's why I'm doing psychotherapy on top of neurofeedback.
One of the things my therapist said today was it says, it sounds like you're on another downward spiral, you know, because I'm back to eating cereal for dinner, not eating regular dinner. I'm back to coming home and sleeping instead of getting stuff done. I haven't blogged in a while, and that's why you waited this long to see part two. And even though I feel fine and I'm stressed about certain things, I'm thinking, what can I do to stop this from happening? You know, I am still having migraines. Today I tried to catch it during the aura, and it's only 10:18 a.m. and I got to work this morning at 7:30. I usually can work through a day with a migraine like this, so it's not as severe. But then again, you know, neurofeedback isn't treating my migraine. I feel like they're caused by stress, but that's just a theory, because every time I'm stressed or my mind's overcrowded, I do get a migraine.
It's 2:55 a.m. and I have a really, really, really bad migraine. I can tell this is going to be one of those nights. Nothing's working right now and I can't go to sleep. I'm in the guest room because I didn't want to keep my husband awake.
As I said in my previous video, I was weaning myself off the migraine medicine because I didn't feel like it was working or doing anything. But I did start back taking that, and that's a beta blocker that I take. I started back taking it probably a week ago. So we'll see. You know, this is all just the learning process, but we will see. I was just told that my office is getting moved. I was granted accommodations where I was able to relocate my office to a quieter place.
I'm going to be reporting to a new supervisor.
Normally, that would freak me out. I'd imagine it would freak anybody out, especially after they just got granted accommodations. You know, I just kind of accepted it, like, you know, what's the worst that can happen? Who knows, the next place may be better.
I went from trying to be optimistic to I'm ready for a vacation. You know, with life comes obstacles. It's just your job to overcome them.
Normally, in times like this, I would maybe try to go to the doctor and maybe get my medicine changed. Whether it's, you know, antidepressant medicine or actual migraine medicine, but sometimes they're afraid to do that because changing the medicine actually can make it worse before it gets better.
The person who told me did not consult with the director of HR about my accommodations, and so it did freak me out a little bit. You know, I'm probably gonna have to start this whole accommodation things over. I didn't start thinking about it until after my therapy appointment, so today when I was in neurofeedback, I feel like it was another setback. I was very distracted. I couldn't focus on the exercises. I really just wanted to go home and go to sleep.
Tomorrow is the start of my new office change, and you know, I have work tomorrow with a day full of appointments in my new office, and
they're taking away the assistant that I have. And if anybody knows me, you know, I'm used to working without an assistant because I do not like asking people for help. And I'm just very independent. In this job, I had to force myself and allow that person to take control of the stuff that I don't have time to handle. I just worry overall that I will not be able to perform 100% if I don't have that help anymore.
You know, it's not the mental illness, it's really just, I guess, the physical illness that comes with the territory. You just feel defeated.
I think about the people with disabilities and what all they have to go through. Nobody wants to go through a whole storytelling again and requesting, and then, you know, just the anxiety of wondering, well, what are they going to think of me?
And although my neurofeedback has been helping and working out and doing meditation and all that stuff, it's just, at the end of the day, it comes down to times like this where you don't feel like anything's going to get better.
You know, taking care of yourself sometimes is the hardest thing.
Because not one thing can just fix everything. Neurofeedback can't fix everything. Psychotherapy can't fix everything. Prescription medicine cannot fix everything. Meditation can't fix everything. Essential oils can't fix everything. But they're all there to assist you, to give you that much relief.
It may not seem like a lot, but it is a lot on you mentally.
Acknowledging that you want help is the first step. You know, we all work at our own pace. You're not doing this for somebody else, you're doing this for you. Hey you guys, it's A.L. Pitts from When Your Brain Hurts, and thank you for watching part 2 of my neurofeedback documentary. I did place a trigger warning on this specific video. I was definitely going through a hard time, and I would never want it to be a trigger to someone else because I know it's sad with me looking at it, reminding myself of what I was going through at the time. And I was going through a hard time. Mental illness doesn't have a look. People are still in bondage, their brains are in bondage, they're going through a lot of stuff. And I just wanted to let you guys know that I'm okay, but I wanted to let you guys know that I'm still going on with the neurofeedback. I believe I'm on my 11th session now. And I want you to stay tuned for part 3. I will be releasing it soon because I'm already working on it and a lot of things have happened since then. So stay tuned, a lot of exciting stuff coming up. Thanks.